Welcome back to Ground TV. The Jamaica Urban Transit Company, JUTC, say it will be deploying additional buses to downtown Kingston in response to reports of potential threats of violence. The company's decision comes after news of potential reprisal action in response to the murder of community leader Harry McLeod, better known as Harry Dog. It has been reported that businesses and shoppers has been told by gangsters to leave the area. West Kingston on edge following murder of Harry Dog. McLeod, 51, was shot several times by unknown assailants at the intersection of Darling Street and Spanish Town Road on Sunday morning. He has been described as the right hand to Kingpin Christopher Dodos Cook, who was arrested on drug-related charges in the United States in 2010. Commissioner of Police Major General Anthony Anderson yesterday said that Kingston West Police were already on the hunt for specific individuals who are believed to be responsible for McLeod's murder. JUTC urges commuters to take all necessary steps to protect themselves and to monitor the media for further updates. Deputy Commissioner of Police Fitz Bailey says a suspect who is believed to be the trigger man in yesterday's shooting of 51-year-old Andrea Lou Garwood is now in police custody. Bailey said the young man turned himself in with an attorney moments ago. Lou Garwood was in a worship session in her church when a man posing as a member of the congregation shot her several times before escaping in a motor car. She was taken to hospital where she was pronounced dead. The DCP also confirmed that the murder was in relation to a family dispute and said one of the individuals now in custody is a family member. He was speaking at the Jamaica Constabulary Force digital press briefing today. Police Commissioner Major General Anthony Anderson also warned the public against contract killings in family dispute during the briefing. Even if you're disposed to do that contract killing, the likelihood of you getting away with it is quite low. In all of these cases, we have persons in custody. These cases have been solved. There may be one or two people we are still after, but largely you will not get away with it. So the property that you think you are going to benefit from by organizing the assassination of family members, of persons close to you, or doing it yourself, that you think you are going to do this and enjoy the fruit of that, it is very unlikely, Anderson said. Two men have been charged by the Clarendon Major Investigation Division in relation to the murder of 36-year-old Reverend Father Larus Lewis. Charged are 22-year-old Lloyd Thompson, otherwise called Danjay, and 20-year-old Tafari Wilson, both of Roxborough District in Clarendon. Lewis, who is of Chapperton, Clarendon, was killed in Chapperton District in the parish on Wednesday, September 23, 2020. The police report that about 4:30 p.m., both accused and Lewis got in an argument when a piece of furniture was used to strike him over the head. According to the police, they then stole a desktop computer, a tablet, a Samsung A10 smartphone from the house, and a 2018 Hyundai Creta motor car. An investigation was launched, which subsequently led to the arrest of both suspects on Friday, January 22nd. Their court dates are not yet being finalized. Everton Beaches Stop McDonald, a popular Portland businessman, has been charged with the 2009 murder of his first wife, Merlene McDonald. The charge now leaves Beaches Stop officially booked for having murdered his two wives. Merlene, 50, was shot in her driveway after parking her car at the Brown Book Port Antonio Portland home May 2009. She later died from her injuries. The latest charge against the businessman was confirmed by the Deputy Commissioner of Police in charge of crime, Paul Fuller Fitz Bailey, at the Jamaica Constabulary Force press conference on Monday, February 1st. It's the latest charge against McDonald actually took place today. It was a cold case that was under investigation, Bailey said. While not disclosing further details surrounding the killing of the woman 9 years ago, Bailey asserted that if persons are involved in contract killings, they will be caught. So if you get involved in contract killings, we are going to find you. It may take a while, but we will find you, he declared. McDonald, then aged 65 years, was charged with the murder of his second wife, Tonya Hamilton McDonald, shortly after her killing in July of last year. Also charged in relation to Hamilton McDonald's killing was 30-year-old Oscar Tiny Barnes of Epsom District in Anata Bay, St. Mary, and 56-year-old Denver Lynn Minot, a fisherman of Ranch Hill in Portland. The three men are jointly charged with murder and conspiracy to murder. Off note, Minot pleaded guilty to murder in September of last year. He was subsequently sentenced to 19 years in prison and ordered to serve 10 years before being eligible for parole. 32-year-old Hamilton McDonald, otherwise called Stacy, a businesswoman of Dolphin Cove in Dolphin Bay, Portland, was found dead with her throat slashed on Monday, July 20, 2020. Her body was just outside a Toyota Oxia motor car that was found engulfed in flames in the Taylorton Main Road in Sherwood Forest, Portland. The police at the time said they had information that suggested that McDonald paid over $3 million to have Hamilton McDonald killed. Indications are that after the killing last year, the 2009 case was revisited by the police, and following the submission of a file to the Office of the Director of Public Prosecution, a ruling was handed down for McDonald again to be charged with murder and conspiracy to murder. Head of the Constabulary Communication Unit, Senior Superintendent Stephanie Lindsay, had said the ongoing conflict between gangs from Tivoli Garden and their former cronies in Denhamtown is the continuation of an old age conflict over turf and extortion. Sections of West Kingston has been under the gun as the rivals take every opportunity to fire their illegal weapons, taking lives and injuring others in the process. Most of the conflicts is between the young generation gang of Tivoli and gangs in Denhamtown. The investigation has shown so far that the main reason behind the gang conflict so far is really to dominate the turf because of the proceeds from extortion. The different gangs are fighting for the same space, SSP said to our newsroom. The feud escalated over the weekend when Harry McLeod, the reputed ex-lieutenant of former Tivoli Gardens Don Christopher Coke, was killed along Darling Street in the vicinity of Carnation Market in Western Kingston on Sunday, January 31st. Lindsay said the police had occupied the space in both warring communities and had taken notes of the efforts of citizens and to protect themselves by erecting barricades and staying indoors. If you go into the communities, you will see them block some of the streets and they remain pretty much indoors, so you will not see the usual hustle and bustle of citizens moving around as they themselves are somewhat fearful, she stated. SSP Lindsay also said the police were aware of the threatening voice notes that were circulated on social media on Monday, February 1st, warning the public to leave the bustling business hub of the capital early as blood would be shed. The voice notes which surfaced after McLeod's murder created panic and even prompted the state-run Jamaica Urban Transit Company to deploy extra buses to assist in the exodus. However, SSP Lindsay pleaded for calm as rumors of heightened violence were attempts to create mischief by criminal elements. We believe that it was a strategy by the criminal network to drive fear and panic among the society and the downtown community. We also anticipated that there could be more problems, so we have systems in place to prevent that from happening. There were some very strategic deployments of assets to ensure that persons could go about their business with as little interference as possible, she stated. SSP Lindsay said that the police leadership of the Kingston Central and Kingston Western Divisions reported that no businesses were closed and people were milling about as usual on Monday and Tuesday.